the class.
Roger that, we'll do.
Has a business and they are accepting cryptocurrency and you want to be added to the directory, message me so I can get you the form that you need to fill out so that we can get all your correct information added to the directory.
Okay.
All right, let me get my screen here going. I didn't even have to pull that up. So today we are actually going to talk about, we're actually going to go over like what each of these platforms are, what they do, and how you can use them. And I mean, blockchain, social media platforms, y'all should know that by now. That's what we're talking about. One that I did want to highlight is Hive. So Hive does a lot of stuff, basically. It allows you to be able to use a lot of different social media platforms. So you can build on it as well. Hold on, let me go over here. This is the part I'm trying to go to. But it also, I use Steam Peak and all those. And so when Steam forked, Hive was the fork. And so not only did the coin split or the blockchain or whatever, also the platforms split as well. So Hive is free to sign up or whatnot to get the actual platform, but some of the platforms to get verified, you got to send like a couple of coins over. But yeah, so basically, I'm going to show y'all everything that was on Steam has the Hive version to it. All these have a Hive version. So it's like Steam, it is Hive. There's Blurt. There's a D-Peak, which was Steam Peak. And so, yeah, that's what I was telling y'all that for, because you'll see like some integrations on those sites. But yeah, we're actually about to go over these. We're not going to go over Brave and Presearch because y'all should know about those by now. And if you don't, shame on you. So the first one is going to be AnyTask that we're going to talk about. And this one is actually, you know, if you do services for other people, this might be something good for you because it's like the crypto Fiverr. Or if you're just looking for services like outside of having to use fiat, because that'd be happening to me like right now. So I'm just, y'all keep wondering, I ain't got no cash, but I got a whole bunch of coin. Like it just be like that sometimes. Sometimes that cash just ran out, but that crypto is always there. So you can find people to be able to complete things for you for as little as a dollar over here. And I really like that. They even have NFT artists. You can hire people to make NFTs for you. But again, you can, if you make NFTs, you can sell your NFT creation services over here, you know? But this is a place that you can come and get services with your crypto, or you can provide services with your crypto. So does anybody have any questions on this one before I move to the next platform? We got a lot of them to get through. So I just want to make sure that we talk enough about each one though. Has anybody here used Fiverr before for anything?
I haven't.
I have in the past.
I've used Fiverr to get videos done, logos made before I learned how to make them. I've used it for people to do SEO research for you. When I used to do house hunting, like when I used to be in real estate, people would find the people's information, skip trace. That's the technical term for it. They would do skip tracing for me. But yeah, you have, again, if you just want to be reselling NFTs too, you can come over here and get somebody who can create some art for you and you can upload it to the blockchain. All right, next one. This next one is Audius. And the best way I can explain this is it works very similar to SoundCloud. They have different tiers versus like if you're staking a certain amount of Audius over here. they do reward the creators, like if they're like win and they have like the most listens, or people are favored in their tracks. So it is beneficial to build up a audience over here. I'm actually getting ready. That's not music over here.
I'm pretty sure you probably said this before, and I apologize for not hearing this, but you said steak audience. Could that get in this demonstration sometime tonight? Where and how do we steak audience? Because I got something just chilling.
We got steak it through here. Like, let me see if I can log in.
Like, I have it in my trust wallet right now. So do I need to move it to somewhere to be able to stake it here, or could I do it from the trust wallet?
Can I answer that, Dash?
No, it would be. Yeah.
Say again.
Yeah.
She's trying to say yes. Yes, please answer.
Okay. So inside your audience, there's an actual wallet address. You have an address. I'm trying to zoom in. I will have to go. Wait a minute. I will have to log into my account, and I'm at work on my phone. So you can link your MetaMask to it. That's one way you can do it. And if the audience is there, then it'll automatically pick it up. But I also have, what's that wallet? Yeah, I have a trust wallet as well. And my trust wallet is linked to was my MetaMask account. And that's how once you link that wallet to it, it'll automatically come up. So whatever wallet you have your audience in, just link it to that. Link whatever wallet you have the coin in, link it to your audience page.
Thank you, brother. I'm gonna do that when I get home.
Yeah, I'm just trying to remember where. I believe it's right. It should be like right there. Yeah.
What is that?
Audio. Yep.
I think maybe it's the settings. Oh yeah, no, this is yeah, it's right
that's
here.
That's it. Connect your wallet, and it'll automatically pick it up. And it's the tiers is like, I believe I think it's over 10. Over 10 is bronze, and then 100 is silver. Yeah.
Oh wow, man, appreciate y'all for this. I just ain't fit this project good enough. So yeah. I'm loving this class right now. I just learned something. This is the definition of engaging, accumulating stake. Like, you can do it all in this one platform. Oh, yeah. Because y'all know y'all get free audience just for coming over here and engaging. Then you can stake that. Man, okay, yeah. Appreciate y'all.
Hell, I learned that from y'all.
Yeah, they got a whole bunch of stuff coming through. So, yeah. This one works just like SoundCloud. You have music over here, like I said, because it works like SoundCloud. I'm actually gonna do some non-music stuff over here too, just audio, because I actually do that on SoundCloud. I do a lot of audio marketing, believe it or not, because it just allows me to get my rants off, and you hear my point, and then you buy. But yeah, this is a way. A lot of my music artists over here actually have NFTs too. That's why I like this platform as well. Does anybody have any questions about the audience platform before we go to the next one?
I do. You said the NFTs. That's what I've been looking for in there. How do you or is it just as soon as you post a track, that's the NFT?
So when I say the NFTs, I mean it's actually somewhere else, but there is their terminology they consider once it's uploaded to their platform an NFT, but you can't purchase from over here. So you got to think about
right. That. Okay.
Now, I also have a question. I know some people here just not asking, but not too many know how to earn money just by engaging with audiences. Is there any way you can do a quick demonstration of how we can actually earn just by logging in, having a wallet, and coming to the site? I can't earn audio, right?
Oh, no, that's if you win. You have to be able to win the contest through here. So let me come back.
I mean, but I thought we was able to earn from like putting music up or even listening to other people's music.
You can earn for putting music up over here, but you have to actually win the contest. That's what I was trying to explain earlier. That's not what
I didn't know that.
But let me come back over here.
Brother Reed, you jumping in the contest yet?
That's what I'm sitting here taking notes as she's going through it. I didn't even know about it. I mean, I'm like I said, y'all showed me a lot about it, and a lot of stuff I found out just by searching around the site, but I didn't know about the contest.
So when you go to the audio and rewards part and you have the trending competitions and it says win, because this feature is not out yet. This is the part where everyone's still like, you know, waiting for it. That's not part of the platform just yet. Right now, to be able to earn, you have to be able to win the contest. So you got the top trending tracks. You have the top trending playlist. Top 5 underground and top 10 API apps. And if you're in those top ones that win, then you win the actual coins.
Hey, I got a suggestion. Let's help each other out, y'all. Group. Y'all come together. Brother Reed has music on Audius. Let's do what it takes to get this man on the top of the charts. Let's promote him. Let's listen to him. Let's tell our friends about it. If we're going to tell him about Audius, let's drop his track. Let's come together as a team. Also, he has his tracks already inside of our social media tab on the Discord. So if you didn't know, go there. You can check some out. He has some music that's really going hard. It ain't just like telling you, do yourself a favor and go listen. You might just like it. You know what I mean? Some things to just really chill out to. Instrumentals that sound really nice. So check out the music. Let's support our own.
Definitely appreciate that, family. We also got 3 albums that we're ready to release right now.
Hey, just let us know how we can help, brother. We don't die. You know me, I'll start posting you on Facebook, try to get everybody to listen. Let's get you on top of the charts.
Definitely.
Like that you gotta be. But I think that's dope.
What was that?
That it gives you can see the numbers here that you need to be. Like the 5th one has 3,000 plays.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I gotta get on my marketing, put on my marketing hat.
I'm gonna have to drop add me fast and I'm gonna drop the links in there, but there's a way that you can kind of cheat code to it too. And I'll drop the link to it later. So is there any other questions about Audius or kind of like what to do over here? You can see like your analytics over here once you click it, or how many plays you got, reposts, how many followers. I only got one song, y'all. One song, same one song. Like this song for almost 3 years now. I'm gonna drop another one day. Not today, but another one. I am.
Hey, we need to get that accumulate song out there. What you talking about?
Yeah, for real.
Now we even got a musician on the team that can help us with the beats and everything. But let's get the track out there. The people want to hear the track, Dad. People want to hear the track.
Hell yeah.
So we got Theta TV. And you guys should know, be familiar about this one. So I won't spend a lot of time on it because we talked about it a lot already. But it's streaming. And I mean, it's not that easy if you don't have a computer that can actually hold the program. And that's like something as far as like usability that we're running into, because it's a big program. As far as the nodes that you need to run, you can stream and build up an audience and, you know, do the VC over here. But as far as actually being able to earn, you got to stream from the node, you got to watch from the node or from your phone. You can do this from your phone. Now that is like the coolest thing. It is difficult to do this from the computer or whatever, but from the phone app, you earn just from showing your bandwidth. So I just literally just let my phone run because it's easier to do this from my phone than on the computer. Who'd have thought, right? But yeah, you're sharing your bandwidth, kind of like BitTorrent type. If you're streaming, I mean, if you're watching from a Theta. So if you, you can watch it on your phone without having to have the node and earn. If you do it from the computer, you actually have to watch from the node to earn. So that makes the difference, because that's such a big program, not everybody can get the node. So if you can get the phone app, you can still earn. Boom. And you can upload a video to Theta once a week.
Yeah, but y'all, this, she finna go through some other ones. Let's look into other ones, because I ain't making no money with Theta. God dang it, I've been doing this for a while, and I don't see the difference yet. But, you know, just let y'all know my experience. I don't get no money from Theta.
Another one is TokenTuber. And this one is very similar to YouTube. The difference over here is they don't like you talking about nothing but crypto. So this is for the crypto only space. To upload over here, you need to have a YouTube video, because every time you you upload it, that's how you do it. You just paste your link over here to be able to upload. Now, I'm gonna be honest, what I use this platform for is to leverage it for just more views. I am earning a tuber. But Tuber is not like blockchain live yet. And what do I mean? I'll show y'all what I'm talking about. You do have to like be mindful of that. You have to know what your goal is going into the platform. Like me, I have two goals. It's earn, but it's also reach, because I market, I have things to sell, and I need a bigger audience. So that is why I might be on some platforms that might have BC, which is virtual currency, opposed to ones that have currency like Mines and PublishOX that I can actually cash out to you know, any blockchain. So when I type in Tuber over here, you'll see this is the token Tuber one. But it's not tracked. So it's still BC basically. It has like Ethereum contract address, but it's not like, it's not live yet. And Mines was the same way. So I need to explain that. Mines was the same way. It didn't, it was virtual currency for a few years. And then, but I was able to use the current, the virtual currency before it was a real currency for advertising, right? So that's what I would leverage it for. And then now it actually is something that I can exchange with Ethereum. So you do need to be mindful of that on these platforms, because some of them is BC and some of them is crypto. But like I said, this is, I'm able to get more views over here just from uploading videos. Like you can see the view counts on a lot of these videos. So if exposure is your thing and you want, this dude is everywhere. If you see him anywhere, just follow him. Just follow this. He got some good information, and y'all can thank him for why I know about all these sites, because I follow Scott's butt on all these dang platforms. Girl, go out, and I'll be looking in his comments and stuff too, like, oh, you there too, you there too, all right, let me get that, let me get that. And that's how I'll find some new, you know, you start, you'll start to notice there are, you know, crypto social influencers, just like there's social media influencers everywhere else. You'll start to notice them over here that actually operate on these platforms. And, you know, that's how I learn about different stuff when it does come out, because I am, you know, staying engaged and staying up to date on the stuff and figuring out what's happening. So you can monetize from in here. You have to log in and it's like some different instructions. But that's another thing. Some of them do connect and allow you to monetize on memberships. Gab is more so freedom of speech. That's what their biggest thing is. Oh, does anybody have any questions on TokenTuber before I go on to the next one? My bad. No?
I mean, I could ask a lot of questions on each and every one of these. You kind of moving fast. I can't write down the notes fast enough. But, you know, I'm trying to keep up. I got you.
So if you just want to be able to say what you want to say, that's where Gab will come in. You will find people who are a lot of accepting of crypto. This is not necessarily blockchain based, but when, what's his face? Little orange dude. He got banned from Twitter. A lot of, yeah, there you go. A lot of his folks came over here as well as him. So again, exposure wise, yep. You can, and you can build tribes over here. So yeah. You don't want to be censored. This is somewhere that you can come and talk, and they have a decent amount of people that's over here following. A lot of people just use their own content from somewhere else that they just posted it to. Like, you gotta pay attention to that. And that's what I do. Like, I'm not about to make a whole, like, 15 different posts. No! I'm about to take that one post and put it everywhere. And you guys will start seeing. I don't know if you've seen, but a lot of people are starting to use BitChute lately. I'm starting to see, like, a lot of people when they're posting news updates and just stuff, that it'll be a BitChute video. I started to notice that, like, over last month, actually. And it's not very common, because, like, usually I'm, like, feel like I'm the only person who knows about these platforms. No, so it is BitChute. I take it back. TokenTuber is not the one that you sync it with, the memberships with. It's BitTube. And I can tell because I can see it up here. So this connects with, what is it called? It's called Star something. But you can basically charge for memberships over here, like, to get access to your content or whatnot. So that's probably the reason why a lot of people are actually using BitChute, because they do allow you to advertise over here and they allow you to monetize. And it's a lot easier because you don't have all those restrictions that you'll find over there on, what's it called, on YouTube. Like, you have to have all those prerequisites to that you got to meet. Like, you got to have a certain amount of watch hours. You got to have a following count. A specific following account, following amount on your account. There we go. Whoo, mercy. To be able to monetize over there. And you don't have to do that with BitChute, which I think that's tight because you're leveling the playing field. Like, I could have some good content. I just might not know nobody yet. Like, let me get a chance to meet somebody. Dang.
That's me.
But. Is anybody have any questions on BitChute?
Yeah, I don't know if I got the part where how we make money. Is it just by posting the videos and people watching them, or is it by charging the subscription? Like, will I get paid for views or what?
Subscriptions over here on BitChute. So you can charge for subscriptions or you can charge for content. Or BitChute.
And is it possible if I want, like, to...
And your followers can tip. I like anywhere where they can tip. Because in the crypto space, tipping is just everyday behavior. Like, here's the tip, here's the tip. Like, they just tip you. You can barely
That's what I want to ask. Would I be able to just, like, drop information and even drop it for free and they just tip me on it? Because I don't want to always have to charge them for a subscription. But, like, what if I just wanted to drop some information and get tipped for that?
Yes. Yes, you can.
Okay, thank you.
And Publish Your X, you guys should be familiar with by now. So we just gonna peekaboo at it. It's a blogging platform. You can embed your videos over here. The easiest way to get accepted is take one of your long social media posts from your other social media profiles and submit it for review. And that way, I've seen that you can get approved in like 48 hours. Any other way, sometimes they don't even approve you. This one does connect to your KuCoin. So you can connect it to your KuCoin and withdraw straight to your KuCoin at 50 cents. And they do that so that you don't have to be worrying about the gas fees. Farm Now, and y'all should look into this platform too. Like, I learned about it from over here because I wanted to know more about it because that's what I was earning, but it's actually a DeFi platform. So it's, like, worth looking into. You can come over here and look into it. But it's actually Harvest Finance, it's Farm, which is pretty dope. But yeah, so if you already creating content, you can just bring it over here. They don't, like, frown upon you doing that. You can just embed your YouTube videos over here, embed your library videos over here, or, I mean, your Odyssey videos, you know. You can even embed, you could talk about your NFTs and embed them over here. So, like, if you're making NFTs, this is a place that you can talk. talk about them, because you can embed your NFTs into your Publish OX post. And I will be actually talking about that later. I'll be having some videos coming on that, because I was like, oh yeah, okay. But yes, you can actually embed it into these posts. But I mean, look at all your Facebook posts you got now. Look at all your Instagram posts you got now. You ain't got no pennies off of there. So I don't even want to hear it when it comes to the amounts, because something is better than nothing. So any questions on Publish OX? We might not even make it through this whole list. We might, though. We might. Any questions on that one? Nope. So read.cash, I do need to say this, because you have to sign in with your words on this one. Like, that's not typical that you would have to use your words. So I don't want even you guys getting comfortable, you know, you doing that. But it is a disclaimer that I need to bring up for this site, because it's not common. Most of the times if something asks you to put your words in, you run like hell. But that's the only way to log into this specific platform. So I need to tell you that. They will give you your words. You will save it. They give you all the stuff that you need from like a wallet. Not your keys, not your crypto. This is really like your content, because you have all your keys, and that's the only way to access it is through your keys. These ones over here, you earn a Bitcoin Cash, which is cool, you know. And it's a blogging platform, very similar to Publish OX, except for they don't have an approval process. And you only earn one currency over here, which is Bitcoin Cash. But you don't need to have a lot of followers over here to earn, which I like that too. So they do have like different communities, like topics. Different groups of people, is what I'm trying to say. And you can see the different topics that people are writing about, that you could read about, you know. So it's not just all crypto, because some, like I said, some of these are only crypto specific, but it's not. And it's like nothing to really just take your article and publish over here that you published on Publish OX, so that you can earn from it as well. That's why I'm telling you, I like doing videos better, because if you just embed the YouTube videos, it just saves a lot of time and headache on getting information over. Because back in the day, I wouldn't even say back in the day like that, a year and a half ago, Google would actually penalize you for having like duplicate content, like the same words here or the same words there. But now they don't care, which means you'll still be seen or won't get ghosted or whatever. All right. So are there any questions on read.cash before I go to the next one? Nope. All right. So Nomad Task, I had got this from this platform called Steam Hunt, which basically you find products that are like digital products and you share them to the site, or you can earn for sharing things that other people uploaded. So like here, you can have people do stuff for you. Like, I'm into marketing, right? And so I have a ClickBank account. So I taught a class on Sunday about a platform called IDPLR, right? And any person that signs up for free to that site, I actually make 20 cents a person. So I could say, okay, well, if I'm gonna make 20 cents a person, I'll give 10 cents a person. You know, so I can come over here and say, if you sign up to IDPLR, I'll give you 10 cents, because for each person that signs up, I'll get 10 cents. And that's what a lot of this stuff is too. They're coming for different things that, you know, give you a commission for getting signups, whether they're free signups or paid signups. And they're offering a little bit. So they're offering people to 23 cents, 400 people worked for 23 cents. You feel me? 87 people for 22 cents. So if you got an app that, you know, will compensate you for other people for sharing it, you might want to come over here to put a task up so that you can get it done for the low. So that's the way. Or you can come over here and complete these tasks and earn the 20 cents. But I always look at it as being able to leverage it and use it. And that's the way that you can actually do it. Like if you do affiliate marketing or anything like that. So is there any questions on Nomad Task? Nope. All right. So this one is a little different. This one is, it's DC, it is. But I like this one because forever in a day, y'all only had 108 Twitter friends. Like it was awful. Wasn't nobody messing with me on Twitter? And if you're in crypto, you know everybody got a Twitter. That's where everybody is. But I like Empire Cred. They actually got it to where you can like make NFTs over here now, but you earn their in-platform currency. For people like investing in you as if you're the stock, I know, right? And you can actually use it to get traffic to your stuff. So again, that's why I like it because I can leverage it for free advertising. Let me see if I can go in here. I'll show y'all because I ran advertising campaigns in here. It connects to your Twitter, like I said. So a lot of people will follow you from Twitter. This is how I grew my Twitter is because of this. Cause I didn't have no friends on Twitter. Like they wasn't messing with me. But what'd I get? Okay, I got stuff. So I have 100 million EVs or whatever, that's their currency over here. But you can actually use it to make missions. That's what I was trying to say, the missions. And the missions are like if you need traffic. So if you need traffic to like, let's say if you wrote a Publish OX article, like this would be the place that you would publish that so that you can have people get traffic to it so that you can potentially earn more. Like, so follow her on Twitter, you're gonna get 32,000 of these E's, you know? Like, okay, we were just talking about some of these platforms have prerequisites when you have to have a certain follower amount on your account to qualify to be able to monetize. So you can come over here and offer for the end platform currency for the VC. You know what I'm saying? And that's literally what that is. Like this is for somebody's YouTube. So they're trying to get YouTube views and you just use the free currency that they give you back into the ecosystem. And that's all I utilize it for. I don't necessarily like complete these because I mean, I've done these from just posting, not completing any of the missions, just posting my missions. So let me.
That's dope. I'm definitely looking at it.
So you can put like, the specific interest, if you want anybody who's in here, if you only want people who are your shareholders, meaning people who have invested in you, you can put the country. I don't know why they call it missions, but like visit a Twitter, visit a webpage, visit a YouTube. You see where I'm going with this? Like I'm giving y'all some gold. Y'all know how much people pay me for this information. Nobody understands how I advertise the way I advertise. Like what? Some heat if you apply it, because that is what we're gonna really talk about, like probably through October through the whole month of October is really just I'm really focusing on the book reports over here, you know, like that's just a way to start building up passive income. There's just too much money that's being left on the table. So that's really what I'm gonna be focusing on, and as you see we have a lot of different platforms that we can leverage to be able to do the book reports. What are the book reports? If y'all don't know what the book reports is, geez, where was y'all last week? Like, no, the book reports are basically giving reviews on different products or platforms that compensate you for referring others to that platform. And you just do it in an educational way so that you can earn more along the way. So just being able, like I said, you should be able to explain pre-search at this point in time. Just being able to do a review on pre-search, you know, putting on any of these platforms, that's 25 pre-search tokens every single time somebody, you know, qualifies, which they need to earn 50 pre-search tokens and be active for 30 days. Will that happen? Yes, I've earned a lot of pre-search tokens just from sharing pre-search with other people. And I do it in an educational way. So Yes, WebTalk is like LinkedIn. I'm trying to get through the whole list, y'all. WebTalk is like LinkedIn, very, very similar to LinkedIn. They do have like premium account that you could buy or whatever, but you earn fiat over here for your posts getting engagement and people following you. You actually earn cash, but it's set up just like these other platforms are set up. And you, you earn from people engaging. And it looks like LinkedIn. You do have to like accept the contacts, you know, you could separate them. This is really more for people to network and sell stuff because you see a whole bunch of people just advertising over here. I mean, do I earn over here? Yeah, I earn over here. You need to have at least $100 to be able to cash out over here. So, are there any questions on LinkedIn? Nope. All right, to Float. And Float, I actually like this one too, a little bit, because it's one of the only ones that is with Bitcoin. So you get a Bitcoin wallet, people can keep you in Bitcoin over here at, for your content. That's why I like it. Another one too, we'll get to it, is Sapien, that works like that. But you can tip, you can have subscribers to where you know you can charge to be able to see certain pieces of your information. They do have it to where you put a live stream over here. But yeah, I mean, Float, I thought I would have just clicked on, let me go to my profile so I can just show y'all. It looked just like regular social media, nothing too fancy. Should be able to click on it. But yeah, so I want to say there's two that I know for sure that you can do Bitcoin on, but a lot of these, they're not with the Bitcoin. Because I mean, that's like the most valuable asset, you know, like, but yeah, that's why I'm kind of partial over here. It just, yeah, it just looked like a regular social media platform. And like I said, you can create subscriptions on this one, like make your own. It's not even clicking. I thought I was gonna go to the whole thing, but it's not. But yeah, you can just put your, I'll put, you know, YouTube videos over here. You can have paid content. That's what I was talking about. You can charge per content, per piece of content over here. But it's one of the few ones that actually syncs with Bitcoin. I mean, that you can, you know, earn Bitcoin with. Steam Hunt is the one that I was talking about earlier, that you find the products or just share the products to earn. This is a spawn of Steam. So it came from all the Steam its platforms. And Steam is like basically the first, the OG of the platforms like this. So you can see like two people, and this one's earned 3 cents, and you just share it basically to your Twitter to be able to be compensated over here. And it connects to your Steam account. Once you got Steam, you pretty much get like 5 accounts when you have Steam it. Like, that's really what it is. And then they all connect too. Once you log in with one, you log in with the same information to all the other ones. And again, it's one of those platforms where you do get your stream, your keys. So that's your content. Because you lose it, you're done. Like, there's no password reset. So I do need to say that. If there's a platform that gives you keys, like access keys, don't lose it. Save it somewhere. Put it somewhere, because there's no password reset on them platforms. It's gone. It's gone. Just like with a wallet, because that is your content. You own the content on that platform. And Steam is one of those. We talked about Bitcoin Cash being one of those. So yeah, that is very, Hive is one of those that gives you the information. So you need to be able to keep that information.
I've been on Steam I've been on Steam it since, sheesh, probably like, I'm gonna say 2016, maybe.
Yeah, maybe that's OG, it's been there.
Yeah, maybe a little bit before then. I have something like, I don't know, I have a ridiculous amount of coin over there. that I can't get to. And you know, that hurts. That really hurts. I mean, it's next time, later on, I'm gonna send you a screenshot of the amount. It's crazy. And I'm just mad that I can't recover the keys. I can't get inside of it. And I'm just staring at this amount that I can't do nothing with. I can see the numbers. I can see the amount. But the crazy part is it'll let me, like, for instance, I can log in to Steam it, but I can't get inside of the D2 platform. That's where all the coins are.
On the DTube side?
Yeah, it's and I've been trying to figure that out. It'll let me log in on one side, but the other side it won't let me log in.
Okay, so if you log in from the DTube side, I'm going to show you that real quick. We're gonna skip y'all real quick to the net to DTube. You can actually log in with your Steam it credentials. So DTube, I think, gives you three different ways to log in. I think it's three different ways you can log in over here. Let me see. Yeah, so right here where it says log in to another network, this is what you want to hit. You want to hit Steam and use your same login with your posting key. Unless you do use the Steam chain or the keychain thing. I didn't have good luck with this. But I just use my same regular Steam information to log in. I don't log in with D2 because, well, I have a similar situation. When they switched over to D2, I didn't fix my stuff right. So I could only log in with Steam.
Right, right. It's the same. I'm having the same issue. Like, I have the posting key. I have the posting key. I have something like, I think the other one's called like an Arthur key and something. It's like three or four different keys I got. And
use your Steam it posted key over here.
Right, right. So I'm gonna try it again later. I don't want to hold you up because I know you got a long list you're going through. But that one right there, I've been trying to figure that one out for like months.
Yeah, look, since we're talking about it, this is DTube, which, so we're going to talk about, well, we might get to DLive, we might not, but DLive and DTube was the same platform when they first started. Yeah, a lot of these platforms are old, just nobody don't know. Like, for real, like, that's why I've still been on them, because they years old. You know, I haven't really tested out the new ones. Like, and there's probably about 8 new ones that I need to really vet and establish a presence on. But this one you can upload straight, like upload the file, or you can take the YouTube link and it'll sync upload it like that. It was all on Steam, then it went to DTube, DLive, and then Steam it has its own. So DTube is for uploading videos. You cannot stream over here. That was what the DLive is for. So they just split it into two different platforms. You can get, Hive, that DTC, or Steam you earn over here. Oh, man, and it froze us up. I was doing good, too, before it started tripping. Can y'all still hear me? Oh, man.
Yes. Oh, okay. Yeah, I can hear you.
But, and then, so what I like about this one is you can't see it. Because it's spiraling, but on this bottom side right here where it says trending tags, you actually can see, you know, what content or what topics are actually doing the better. There you go, right over here. So music, vlogs do really well over here. Life, but look up here, gaming. So this would be a good area to, you know, you see the YouTube right there because this was uploaded straight from YouTube. So definitely think about that if you already use a YouTube. But this is the place where you can actually upload your gameplay to, you know what I'm saying? Or snippets from your gameplay that already has a society of gamers, which is dope, right? Which one was we on? BitTube. Oh, I love BitTube, y'all. I like it because they like to let me send my stuff to help whoever I want to, as many people as I want to. So the only way now, like, to share YouTube videos, you got to share. You can inbox your videos to your followers over here or groups that you're a part of. And I like that because I can do like 100-something people and not go to Facebook jail, you know? And this one, actually, you can, so you get Tube, which is not the same as Tuber. But this one has a VPN extension, so you can use the coins that you actually earn to run the VPN, which is called Airtime. So they have Tube, and then you got like this in currency, it's like X something. But long story short, I like this one for that. I get way more views over here. You can upload pictures over here too. Like, I'll upload a video and it'll, I want to say Tube is even out too. Hold on, let me come over here to CoinMarketCap. I could upload a picture and it get no love on Facebook. I'll come have like 1,200 views on that same post. Like, are you kidding me? So that's why I like BitTubers, because they like me better. They used to have a different interface. They changed it. It was a little different back in the day. Let me see. Oh, yeah, we made it. No, we made it. It's over. I mean, it's groove. Like, it's live. Let's see what markets this is on. And I just be, you know, staying with these projects, because some of them, they don't be, okay, Bittrex, that's where it was. I got a Bittrex account. So you can cash it out over there on Bittrex. It's not a lot of volume over there, but that is worth knowing. Because at first you couldn't for a second. It was just VC. But yeah, they have an actual VPN add-on, like a browser extension. And as you're like on your computer, it's running up, you're earning for just being on your computer, hence the airtime. So if you have that extension, you're actually earning while the BitTube extension is running. And that's how I've got my coins, is the actual, not the site, but the actual BitTube extension that I have. And that's how I've actually been able to get my Tube coins from there. Just from being on the computer. So they actually compensate you for what's called airtime, which is just being on the computer. But again, it is where you can upload your videos. And I'm telling you, if you've got issues getting views on YouTube, come over here. They'll like you. They will like you over here. They will. And you can live stream over here as well. I got 5 minutes. I'm trying to get it up, y'all. Is there any questions on BitTubers? No? Okay. I'm trying to make it through all of it. Why don't
Yep. Hey, I just want to let you know, I got about 1,000 questions, but I'm driving, so I'm going to watch that close. I'll hit you up with some questions after I watch the replay.
Okay.
You got some amazing stuff you're sharing on here. It's blowing me away.
Hey, Brother Damon, you and me both, let's sit together and watch it. We do a watch party. I got to rewatch this again, too.
Hoorah, brother.
I'm definitely putting, like, the last 3 months of the year, a lot of my energy is going to be over here on blockchain social media and doing book reports, because it's just, I mean, once you're in crypto, all you talk is crypto. So it's just being able to articulate it in a certain way on a platform. It's the same thing. You can't shut up about it, but you'll actually find people who want to listen to you over here. Like, I love it because they like me. They like me over here. They don't really be messing with me on that regular social media. I'm just trying to explain. I don't even got to come up. I could show up once every 3 months and still not lose my following. And that's dope. I like mines because, again, you can monetize on your content, meaning charge per piece of content. You can do blogs over here. If you do Mines Plus, you actually can earn in a rev share. And I'm actually getting ready to do that. You just got to pay like their like yearly membership or whatever. And then you could do that. But you can still earn without having Mines Plus. It's just you can stream. Like, you can have Mines TV if you have Mines Plus. And that's what I want to do, is open a TV station over here. But I like this because you can, again, use your tokens to pay for advertising. And when we first, like when the coin came out, it's only like 40 something cents, 37 cents. And now it's a few dollars per token, which is dope. You can do fiat over here. I just don't. But yeah, like a half of mine's coins, 500 views, a whole one, 1,000 views. And you can charge per piece of content and you can have subscriptions over here. It's lit. It's like Patreon, but social media style. I don't know how to explain it, but it's lit lit.
Like what was the one they shut down? OnlyFans.
Yeah, kind of, but not.
But yeah, not to that extent, right? Like you said, the Patreon.
So I do want to talk about DLive because I know we're running short on time as far as going through this list, and we'll pick up on some more of these a little later. Should we run out of time? But if y'all got time, I got time. We don't got that many more to go, but if you gotta go, you gotta go. DLive is a great place for gamers. Like any person that I've put over here, they immediately start getting tipped and earned. They do have it to where you can cash out to your PayPal. You do have subscriber requirements over here, but if you're gaming, like you should definitely be over here too. Because they're allowing you to stream over here. And I mean, it's a clique of gamers. Like this is what people do over here. They do got news and they got people who do like talk show type stuff over here, but you do earn them. Like people tip you lemons. And then once you have a certain amount, you can cash it out to the equivalent. But this is the other part from D2. When they split up, this is only live streaming. You do have to, come to like a certain amount of subscribers to be able to upload or save videos over here. You used to just straight upload or whatever, but now you can't. But yeah, this is a good place to come if you want to start growing your gaming community. And guess what? If you know some cheat codes on the games that you're playing, you can have subscriptions over here. And only your subscribers will see those cheat codes to your games. I'm just like, there's just so many ways to monetize when it comes to blockchain social media. I haven't been doing it enough justice as far as explaining all the possibilities to everybody. So that's the purpose of this class today, so that we can really sit down and talk about them. But going forward, I'll probably be breaking down just like two or three of them at a time, like how to post on them and, you know, upload content or, you know, any little differences that are about those platforms. I probably only do two or three at a time going forward. But gaming, that's really something that would be worth looking into. We talked about Odyssey a lot, which is library. So I'm just gonna peruse over that one just a little bit. Again, you could charge per piece of content. You actually reward it for watching content. They have daily rewards. They have different milestones that you can accomplish, and you reward your library credits for reaching those milestones. And one of them is the daily watch reward. So if you watch videos daily, you will earn daily over here, and that's great. You can upload content, and this is one of the best platforms to receive tips on. On this one, like people be tipping old, years old content too. You do need, I think, 300 friends to be able to sync your YouTube over here. But outside of that, yeah, this is like one that I would suggest in for beginners. So like, if you want to talk about like what's liquid, what's easy to use. When I say liquid, it means easy to get your coins out and all that. I would do Mines, Library, which is Odyssey, and PublishOX. If you focus on them three, you can branch out to the others, but them three are your most lucrative, the most easiest to earn on, and they're the easiest to get your money out of. So PublishOX, Odyssey, and Mines. And all of those platforms actually reward you whether you post content or not. So that is something else to be mindful of. If you just not the posting type and you're the viewing type, you might want to put your energy towards those specific platforms. But if you are a content provider or a business owner and you got stuff that you want to get out there to the world, then, you know, expand your reach. And that, then I definitely behoove, I think would behoove you to do omni-channel marketing, which is what basically this is. This is not the complete list of all the places that I actually have profiles on, because I have every traditional one. I have YouTube, Twitter, Reddit, Moco Space, all that. So, yeah. But we're going to say wait till the end of the year. Y'all were like, man, I thought she was crazy, but dang. Okay. Sapien is one I really haven't talked about a lot. And it's like, I mean, they actually love good content over here. You can't be playing with these people about their content, because they complain if you don't. Because, yeah, there was a time when I was just speed posting. I don't even care what I was posting. And, yeah, I got reprimanded over here for it. It was like, nah, you don't want that. Put some heart in your post over here. But podcasters, video creators, writers, this is a good place. You can earn Bitcoin over on this one, too. You have like different tribes. So it's kind of like Reddit a little bit. It's kind of like Reddit and Tumblr mixed to me, if you guys been on Tumblr before. It's not even gonna let us see it without being logged in. And I know this one will freeze up my computer. But yeah, this one is one that you can actually earn Bitcoin on for being tipped and engaging into the platform, which I like, but this is one of the ones that actually more so rewards content providers. But again, I like it. I'm a content provider. Shoot, I got some Bitcoins on that one. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. So Me Social. This one, that's why I know I went through all these and then I kind of skipped around, because this one I'm actually thinking of maybe like removing from my list temporarily. This is connected to the ONG coin. But they was having some wallet issues. So right now, this would be on my end as far as reach wise, not monetary wise, until they get that fixed. Cause you're really supposed to be earning over here. I can pay for advertising over here. I still can do that. But as far as, because I got a couple hundred dollars stuck in this platform, I do know that you had to pay to get verified in order to get your money out, which, you know, just use your content the rewards that you've already got. But something has been going on with getting it out of here as of recent. So I would not bank on that till that's figured out. But as far as reach wise, I actually do have a pretty good following over here. And that's what I didn't say, and I guess I should have. Some of these, you can actually do like fan pages, like you can do fan pages. You can create your own groups like you can over there on Facebook. So they do have different features like that as well, and messaging as well. So they do have different stuff like that in some of these that I did not mention that, because that was just a lot to go through. But we will keep, you know, digging and chucking away on these different things. But I did need to give that disclaimer, bring that up, because I've just noticed that over there when I go to my wallet, it just been sticking. So yeah. And then let's go over here to Steam It. This is the OG. This is where all of the rest of them was born from, is Steam It. Again, don't lose your keys over here, because you can't get back in. There's no password reset. There's no password reset. Let me say it last time. There is no password reset. Save your keys wherever you have to save them at. This is one that's ruled by what they call whales. So for one, they're trying to get some momentum back over here to Steam It, because Hive has basically stole all their clientele since the split. They do have a Tron integration now. Have I figured out how to do it? Nope, my Tron's not connected, because I haven't figured out how to get it connected, but I still got my Steam and my Steam dollars. So it's the two currencies that you get over here, Steam and Steam dollars. It's set up like a blogging platform. So you can't just like post a picture. It has to have like some words to it. Kind of what the posts and stuff look like over here. But I mean, it was the first platform that I was on. It was the first one I started earning on. And it is the oldest platform. So posting over here is a little tricky sometimes, because it's a little more technical if you're trying to do certain things, but you can embed a lot of stuff and customize it if you do know light coding or what's that called, that CSS. this is one of those ones. They used to have a Steam Bay over here, so where you can like do auctions by popping a code into your post, but that quit. I wish that didn't stop. That was pretty neat. And we already looked at DeanTube, and Steam Peak is just like Steam, it just prettier. And you can actually see your earning potentials on this one. So I'm actually, oh yeah, they moved to DP. Come on, let me get over there. Yeah, there you go. Or Peak D, I'm talking about DP. Peaked. So yeah, the Hive split over to Peak D, which is still Steam Peak to me, gosh dang it. Like I said, you can see like how much your potential earnings are. It's just a cuter version of Steam, basically. Pretty much the same, except for this over here. Instead of Steam, it's on Hive. And you can like pull Hive up on CoinMarketCap. We looked at that. And I say that you got a lot of options and there's a lot of things to talk about. Even just being able to talk about, you know, these platforms, you'd be able to earn from people thinking like, oh, well, maybe I should be over there. There's a lot of stuff in crypto that they give us that we can talk about, like if you're using the Fold app, if you're using the Lolly app, if you're using Presearch, if you're using PublishOX, Celsius, Voyager. These are all these things are things I use that I have accounts on. That why if I'm using it and I have an account on it, somebody else might think it's cool. How many people are using KuCoin? Did y'all know you had an affiliate link for KuCoin? Just being able to write an article and explain what KuCoin is and that you could trade with leverage could potentially get you some coins. And that's what I really want y'all to know, because that's where my focus is. You'd be like, Dad, you ain't no, there's nothing new for me to talk about. It's time to get these middies. I'm talking this time. It's time to get the middies. So I'm letting y'all know, plan for these last 90 days. League of Kingdoms, you know, being able to explain that blockchain game. OpenSea, just telling people you can buy and sell NFTs on OpenSea and write an article on it or review a video and posting it on any of these. Stocking up your NFT fund, you know what I'm saying? You can actually get free NFTs sharing Unstoppable Domain, because every person who uses Unstoppable Domain because you can pay $50 a person. So every four people is a free NFT. Gala Games. Who's playing Gala Games? It has a link or referral on it. Splinterlands. If you're playing Splinterlands, do a review on it. Sandbox. We all know what Sandbox is. Did you know you could be earning from Sandbox? From sharing. Sharing is caring, but if you do it the right way, it's also profitable. And that's what I'm saying. These are all things that I actually use, that I have an account on every single one of these platforms. So if I have an account on it, why would I not take the time to just do at least one review so I can earn passively along the line? That don't make no sense to not do that to me. Everything that I use, if it has an affiliate link to it, I'm going to go find it. Just saying, I like to offset my expenses, y'all. I'm trying to explain. And we looked at some of them. I don't think they're all on there. That's why I came over here. Oh, yeah, I don't think BitRefill is on there. My Constant. But again, I just give myself a whole bunch of list of items and things that I can talk about that I can, you know, refer others to. And there's a whole wide open playground of places that I could post to, because y'all know Facebook and them don't like that stuff. Okay, but the blockchain love it. So run me my biddies, and that's the end of class. So what questions do you guys got? I'm gonna stop the shit. I did held y'all over.
I don't have a question, but you gave me a really, really good idea.
I'm glad.
But we'll discuss, me, you, and Dennis can discuss that later.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we gotta talk anyway. So yeah, definitely.
Yeah, look, sure. And I'm already about to be putting your NFTs on my sites and stuff, because you know. Just letting you know, you see some random sales coming through, it might be your girl.
Please, by all means. We got another collection I've been working on. Something that's more traditional, like the more traditional style NFTs.
Yes, most definitely. And that's the coolest thing, right? Like, I just, you know, was kindly enough to say something, but all I had to do was just put my tag at the back of there, and the actual contract will compensate me for sharing his artwork. That's what I'm saying. Sharing is caring,
but yeah,
it's profitable.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's that's what, like Dennis say, we got to talk. We definitely got to talk about that, because I just recently got put on to that. I didn't know that was possible. I just saw that not too long ago.
Yes, so definitely. Yes,
but I know I ain't going to hold y'all up. I appreciate the info. And we will set up a time where all of us can definitely chop it up.
Most definitely. Does anybody else have any questions? I know we went over a lot, and well, y'all pretty much have the scope of what we're going to be talking about for this fall. So if we don't get the questions answered today, I definitely will make sure to at least, you know, go over in a future class or make a video on it. But ask the questions still, whether class is over or not. Drop them in the chat so that they can be addressed, and I know which points to highlight on going forward. Because I don't want nobody leaving no coins on the table. There's a lot of coins we're leaving out here on this table. It's time to go pick them up. So, with that being said, I'll let you guys out of here. Blessings.